Hey, this is Red Band coming to you live from Houston, Texas, at the Secret Group for a brand new episode of Kill Tony. Here's Tony Hinchcliffe. Hello, Houston. Fucking noise. This is so quiet. Yes, this thing isn't working.
Oh, I don't do that.
Jesus fuckers. Christ. You guys are right. Troll, how's that possible?
It's just
that's mic one.
It's just loose.
This is what we go over this every week.
It's just the loose one.
It's oh, the give me the loose one then. That makes sense.
Oh, this isn't working.
Hey, hello. Live sound check. Who loves it? Who loves it more than me? Guess what, baby Tony's favorite thing is.
It's a
hey. Yep, that's not gonna work. Fuck yeah. I guess that's why they call it the secret group. They want us to whisper to everybody, keep it secret, everything that happened here tonight. Josh Martin, ladies and gentlemen, is here. The great producer of Kill Tony is here in Houston. Mic one doesn't work, Josh. Good thing we brought you all the way from Los Angeles to here for this special road show. Mic one worked better last time we were in Houston when you weren't here. Who was here at the last show that we did here, huh? Who loves Kill Tony out there? Anybody? Aphrodite. Ichabod. Wow, this guy, you need to smoke more pot, sir. There's certain things that I want everybody to erase from their memories, and that's definitely one of them. I'm glad I'm not even going to repeat it into the microphone, make everybody...
Hey, who was at the Houston show heard what the one audience member said?
Have you guys go to some kind of thread to find out what happened there just now? Life is good.
Yeah,
I'm excited. We just had a blast in Austin, Texas. I'm super pumped. Let's just jump right into it. Should I bring up the guests or what? Let's just wait.
Let's wait for the sound. Hey, by the way, we have a comedy show right after this show.
Who loves stand-up comedy? I love stand-up, too. We're doing a show after this. Let's just say maybe I'm booked at a club in a city and I can't mention who's on the show. If I was doing it, but there's a whole show, but I wasn't allowed to mention that I was doing the show.
Yeah,
a bunch of awesome comedians. The hit secret show that is a big hit in LA is here tonight. When you're going to get to see a ton of awesome stand up after this, if you come to that show as well.
Yeah. A lot of secret guests on that are in town.
We're going to use one of the operational mics during the stand up show, if you're wondering. You're like, I wonder if they're going to use the janky mic. Keep it interesting, you know what I mean? Keep it a real live show. We're going to be using an operational microphone. And what the fuck else? Did I stall long enough?
Oh, I think we also might have some Kill Tony posters, some of the new posters after the show.
The brand new Kill Tony poster, guys. So. You're the first people to ever get it sold live to anyone because we did not sell them at Moon Tower.
No, completely.
completely Josh fucked up. Not we.
Not we.
Josh. We fucked up, he just said. both Josh and Martin fucked up. You are correct. We fucked up. Let's bring up some guests. Who loves guests, huh? Oh boy, we do. Guys, I mean, I'm so fucking excited about this. Literally, my only other favorite podcast, other than Kill Tony, is The Legion of Skanks. And I present to you, Luis J. Gomez and Dave Smith. Make some motherfucking noise! Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Holy shit! Fuck yeah! Welcome, welcome! We're about to have a motherfucking blast!
What's up, guys?
Welcome, welcome! Dave Smith!
Very unprofessional so far, Tony.
Dave, first time on... I know, Dave, it's your first time on the show. Luis, you've done it before. Welcome back. Should we even mention? I think you know. You want to do something crazy and mention the thing we were talking about out back? The event.
You
want to
talk about it? Fuck it. Let's announce this bitch right now on Kill Tony.
Right now, We're going to exclusively announce right now.
Hold on. You haven't even asked Brian yet.
Yeah. Have we even talked about it?
No, you have not asked me yet.
Yeah, we just talked about it. The last Sunday in
June.
We
are going to rape Brian Redband's girlfriend.
Maybe. Hold on. I have to check my calendar. But hold on. Let's do breaking news, and I'll check my calendar and give you a...
Check your calendar.
All right.
Oh, whoopsie daisy. It's breaking news coming in. Skankfest, first of all, the new coolest number one festival in all of New York City. For those of you many listeners that we have in New York City, the hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of listeners that we have in New York City.
Make it sexy, Tony.
Skankfest is a huge festival in New York. You available?
What day?
It is June 23rd, 24th, and 25th.
Well, we want you guys for the 24th or 25th.
Hey, a lot of you guys are fans of comedy, and you've probably wondered, how does booking work?
You're finding out live right now. Very rarely.
This is a little pull behind the curtain.
No, it's great. It's like a fucking comedy documentary in front of a live audience.
June 25th, Kill Tony's going to New York City for Skankfest. How about that?
Kill Tony, New York City!
Could be the 24th, might be the 25th. Keep a close eye on it on social media at skankfest.com.
It's actually my stepmom's birthday.
So we're going to rape his stepmom instead. Fuck yeah!
It's Diane's birthday. I saw it in the actual thing. He wasn't lying.
It's not like I raped your real mom.
Yeah, you can't even really hold a grudge if you rape somebody's stepmom. You're like, you'd be mad at him for like a week.
Don't think of it as me raping your stepmom. Think of it as me raping the chick who's banging your dad. You know?
You guys that were at the last show had a special treat because we had a band member with us that time, and that was cool. It was the great Jeremiah Watkins. Unfortunately, budgetary reasons.
Well, he's in the hospital also from last night's incident.
Yeah, we have
incident.
Two reasons why he couldn't be here tonight.
True, sir.
So instead, you're just going to have to deal with the Kill Tony band. Jeremiah Watkins, ladies and gentlemen. The one, the only, stole last night's episode in Austin, Texas. You know him from Kill Tony, the roast battle, the goddamn comedy jam. Jeremiah, welcome to the show. How's it going, my man?
It's great to be here, guys. I had to go to an Indian reservation down the way to get healed from getting injured last night in Austin. So now there's a Native American man living inside of me.
Oh!
And he gave me this wolf shirt.
I remember seeing this. I remember the Indian man making an appearance on the show from you before.
He was on the last episode of Houston.
Oh, that was here.
Yes, he was. Oh. My son is somewhere around here.
I'm very excited to have you back on, Indian Man Jeremiah Watkins. The place is, it seems like everything is all set. Should we get this motherfucker started? You guys know how it works. A bunch of random people. Sometimes your local awesome comedians. Sometimes it's completely fucking insane people. Last night, I gave it the same setup, and in the middle of a show, one of the names we pulled out, the guy was completely off his gourd. He was on mushrooms. His opening line was, "I'm on mushrooms and fuck." I believe his next line was, "Blockbuster's crazy." And then Jeremiah made fun of him at the end of his 60 seconds. And he got physically attacked. There was a human being that had to get dragged off the stage. The video is already up on Vimeo. You're going to get to see it soon. I'm pretty sure we're about to be on... Kill Tony's about to be featured on World Star. But Jeremiah Watkins stood his ground with a saxophone in his hands, fended the guy off, and... So there's a bunch of names in this bucket. If you get pulled out of the bucket, you get... an uninterrupted 60 seconds to do whatever you want. And then afterwards, we talk to you about anything in the world. Maybe about your set a little bit. Maybe just find out more about you. You're a guest on a podcast all of a sudden. You have to stand there and take it.
Tony, I'm sorry. I'm new to the show. At what point do we get to fuck the young comics?
Well, you could pretty much... they do that to themselves once they sign up for the bucket, actually. Okay, cool. You get an uninterrupted 60 seconds. You know your time is up when you hear the sound of a kitten. I can't really hear that, Brian. Why don't you turn it up a little bit? There, it almost is. Even that would be good for the first one. Maybe just leave that volume button all the way up. No? wrap it up then, or else you're going to bring out the angry West Hollywood bear. You don't want to go over your time. That's the whole thing. All right, I guess it's just... There you go.
Do people from Houston know what a West Hollywood bear is, though?
It's the Dallas bear.
There we go.
The Dallas bear. The Dallas Buyers bear.
It just seems like everyone from Houston hates Dallas. Yeah, see,
whoa,
everyone hates
Jesus.
Dallas.
All right, lady, relax. Okay. Yes. This is how it starts.
Dallas. I hate
Dallas.
Cowboys.
I'm from Dallas. Roadhouse was in Texas, right?
Cowboys are my least favorite team. Oh.
And we have begun. I pulled a name out of the bucket. Your first comedian doing an uninterrupted 60 seconds tonight goes by the name of Sun Tran. Here he comes. He's coming up. Here's Sun Tran, everybody. Clap for Sun.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, guys.
What the fuck, man? What the fuck,
Nobody
man?
Likes Canada. All right. But good news. Last fall, I became an American citizen after 10 years. I'm one of you guys now. Thank you very much. Yeah. Perfect timing. Perfect timing. I did not see that coming, guys. That was, you got me. That was good. But I'm hoping the Trump administration is going to do the right thing. You know, I'm hoping they'll let my wife and kids stay with me in the same internment camp. That'd be nice. You know what I mean? It's a weird time we live in. You know, it's a weird time when you hear a story about your president getting peed on by Russian hookers. And your only reaction is to wait for the weird part. You know what I mean? Like, that's just a setup. Like, he's in Russia. He had dinner. They peed on him. Here's where it gets crazy, guys. No, but it's good. I got a couple of kids. I got my daughter, Chloe, and I got a son, too. That's his name, son, too. He's, Thank you very much. He's a good kid. He can beat me in video games now. He beat me.
Oh, whoa, I know.
Was that a cat? Or was that
yeah, at all.
It's a larger cat than I thought it was going to be.
I gave you four cats.
Thank
Calm
you.
Down.
That was his pet.
That was very good. Sorry about the mic problems at the beginning. I gave you an extra 5 seconds. How long have you been doing comedy?
What's going on right now? What are you doing, Brian? Just complimenting him and then randomly asking questions because you didn't hit the cat noise loud
I
enough?
Hit it four times.
And we all know what's happening. You realize
who heard the cats?
Nobody.
This guy did.
He didn't. That guy wants
four
attention.
I did this cat. Four times?
That's not loud enough.
And then I did this cat.
Clap your hands if you heard the cat.
But oh, you guys are lying. You're
Brian.
Just clapping out of habit at this point. Because everything that I've said, you clapped for.
Brian.
What do you hear the fucking cat?
I hate to say it, but the smoke signal in the back was louder than the cat noise.
Yeah, that's good. That'll be the new thing. Make loud thunder the new for today, since it's based on the sound system. This is kitty friendly.
When Brian made the cat noise, did you get hungry?
Oh. Yeah.
It's a real question.
What kind of Asian are you?
What kind of Asian am I? I'm Vietnamese, that kind of Asian.
Whoa. I don't want to start with you. You guys do not give up. You realize they beat us in that fucking war? We don't ever talk about that much. Vietnam beat the shit out of us. Bunch of little fuckers like you. Did your dad fight on the Vietnamese side?
Yeah, he did. Actually, that's why we're here. He had to leave because he was fighting with the American side. So Wait. After the war is over, is either go to prison or flee the country.
That's
so
great. Your dad was just like, I'm going on Team America. They're here to stay.
Yeah.
Yeah. America was like, ah, this is getting bloody. We'll see you later. Yeah. And I was like, fuck.
He was also surprised by the results of that one, yeah.
I got to say, one thing, and I think Brian did say that, but he said it in the midst of trying to cover up his own fuck-up. But very impressive that the mic didn't work and it didn't fluster you, because this isn't just a stand-up comedy set. You're being judged by comedians that have been doing it for a while, and you didn't let it, you didn't flinch for a second. You went right into your bit, very comfortable.
There was a second, actually, when the mic sound went out and you were still talking, where I looked underneath you for subtitles to see, like, true Asian style. My joke is not over.
What is going on with this microphone?
That was
I didn't think the microphone was off. I thought it was just going to take another 30 seconds for him to start speaking. Right. Oh, there it is.
Even my setups get laughs. What's the most Vietnamese thing about you?
The most Vietnamese thing about me?
Yeah.
My name. Eats cockroaches.
My name, that's the most Vietnamese thing about me. It's I never got an English name when I came over here, so Son is actually my Vietnamese name.
Huh. Yeah. And when he plays...
And I guess my DNA, that would be also Jeremiah? Very Vietnamese.
And when he plays Monopoly, he only collects the railroads.
Jeremiah motherfucking Watkins is in the house. Jerry. There's people trying to start a Jerry Springer chant for Jeremiah. It's true. Joel does have Joelberg now. Maybe we do.
This is funny, but painful too. But it's funny though.
Thank you for judging us.
No worries.
Yeah. Thanks. So Sun Tran. That's an interesting one. What'd you name your kids?
Marshall.
Oh, yeah, super white.
Yeah.
My son's name is Sergeant.
Has really
and
Chloe
direction. Is the daughter.
Yeah, he named them after the law they're going to use to take your stuff.
I'm sorry?
No, you don't need to, if you don't hear it, son, just keep nodding and saying yes.
Just keep smiling. That's good.
Very good. Very good. Yeah. What do you do for work? How do you make a living?
I'm a lawyer for a living. That's what I do for work.
I apologize for everything.
No worries.
Yeah.
Wait, are you a trial lawyer?
No, I work for a company. I'm a corporate lawyer.
Ooh, what company?
Direct Energy. Can I say that? Direct Energy.
Damn.
Too late.
I know, by the way, I don't even have anything against it, but is there anything that sounds more evil than I'm a corporate lawyer for Direct Energy?
Yeah.
God damn it.
Yeah, not very sympathetic, I know.
What kind of energy is that?
We're siphoning sunlight.
Just power and gas.
Yeah.
So, for all your home needs, if you want to call Direct Energy,
very creepy. Not only am I the lawyer, I'm also the marketing director.
There you go.
We're taking a real grassroots podcast thing that we're doing.
Are you trying to sell his listeners at home right now?
Yeah, sure. Why not? Job security, you know? So.
That's brilliant, dude. You don't play to the fucking couple hundred in the room. You play to the fucking 100,000. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. If they see a spike in signups, I'll tell them why. So.
Son, sometimes I have no idea what the fuck you're talking about.
It's corporate stuff.
I thought you said some tran. I thought it was going to be some trans dude that walked on the stage.
Now, an interesting part of last night's show... for those of you that do listen to the podcast, it was that there was an embarrassing part where a comedian talked with me about working at a pizza parlor in Corpus Christi. Yeah. And I was embarrassed of working that weekend, and I made a whole joke about it. And because I thought that no one was ever going to find out about it. That's the only comedy club in Corpus Christi, by the way, is this fancy pizza parlor. But then when I got there, I realized that it was a fucking pizza parlor. I mean, in a pizza parlor, it's just a pizza parlor. Exactly. So, last night, the guy that opened that show was on the show, and he goes, yeah, I worked with you at a pizza parlor in Corpus Christi. And, son, you were actually the feature at that.
Yeah, that was us. Yeah, we did the pizza
at
parlor.
At that pizza parlor in Corpus Christi.
Same microphone,
And the
too.
Crazy thing is that at that show as well, the sound went out for you.
Yeah.
Fun fact. Just fun facts.
So, we're saying maybe it's you.
Could be me. I don't know.
Yeah.
Could be they really do hate Canadians. I don't know.
Some sort of crazy Asian voodoo that you're doing on the microphones here.
What do you like to do when you're not just doing stand-up or working for the devil himself?
Oh, yeah. I got a couple kids, so most of my time is spent, yeah, you know, driving.
Binding his daughter's
so.
Feet and hitting his son when he's not reading. That's what they do. Get some culture.
Do you get your Asian children, like, yeah, I had one of those, like, you know, you ever have one of those, like, little cars, the Power Wheels or something like that? Do your Asian children just, like, roll down the stairs in those and shit? Because in L.A., I'm not going to lie, son, I've always said this, the most true stereotype out of any race ever, yeah, out of them all.
Black Asian dude, big dick.
No, even more so than black dude, big dick is...
No.
I will take this down with you. We will go. I will pay for one of those fucking tests. We'll get 50 random black dudes. Look at the average size of their dick. And
come,
50,
and then come.
50 Asian guys, yes.
Let me tell you the problem with this comparison is it's hard to measure how bad a driver versus how big a dick you have.
Like, you would be shocked. Is your wife Asian as well?
She is, yeah.
Okay.
Could drive better with his dick than an Asian.
How many times has your Asian wife run into something?
Never.
What? You're a fucking liar.
That's crazy.
I've been speeding tickets. That's about it, though. Nothing ever hit, so.
I've been dating an Asian for only, like, 7 months, yeah, and she's been in 3 car accidents.
Yeah.
I promise you. Yeah. And it's all been things like on the side. Like, I don't think she can see on the sides.
See, you're. Yeah. Yeah. You guys need a farther side view mirror, like over here, instead of out here. So your wife drives a lot. She comes home, and the car doesn't have a ding on it, is
what
you're saying.
No, no dings. No, just some speeding tickets.
The only ding on your car is your other child. We didn't get its name. But have you ever thought that maybe your Asian wife, who definitely hits shit in her car, has just been fucking an auto detail repairman?
Could be.
There he is now. Oh, here he comes. Trans son.
Give me a kiss.
Hello. Hello, Mr. Tran.
That's just ignorant, Tony.
I know, I love it. It's not my Asian impression. That's insulting to Asians to do that voice.
That's like the one that we can still get away with Asian racism.
It's specifically a North Korean impression that I'm doing.
Yeah, there we go.
North Koreans I do impressions of because they hate us and it's okay to make fun of them. Yeah.
Oh, for North Korea. Oh,
I'm so stupid. Our missile.
Oh, yeah. And I don't know about you, but, like, I checked the Legion of Skanks heat map, and it can show you where the listeners come from. And in North Korea, we have zero.
Zero,
so
zilch.
I wouldn't worry about. It's not going to get back to them. Like, you can say whatever you
want. Your podcast not funny. Ho, ho, ho.
We not allowed the internet. They don't allow us to do it.
Dude, don't you agree that everyone should be allowed? Everyone should be allowed to do a cartoonishly goofy impression of a voice of every racial group. It's just the most fun thing.
Yes.
It should be like in the Constitution.
Let's start right now. Like, son, do a black guy
I'm not going to do that.
Come on, son. Do a black guy. Do a black guy.
Do a black guy. Do a black guy.
I'm pretty sure.
Your wife would do it.
I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure people from work are listening to this podcast too, so I'm just going to pass on that one.
Do you?
Oh, like a true corporate lawyer.
Yeah. Do you remember when Kill Tony jumped the shark and they bullied an Asian man into doing a black guy voice?
Jumped the shark?
I keep forgetting you're behind me and then I hear this voice and nobody's talking and I'm like, what?
Ooh, I keep a forgetting. No, I'm kidding. I'm sorry. I said it was North Korean. I was lying, son. I'm a racist.
That's okay.
Maybe driving is the second biggest stereotype. Yeah. No. Well, son, I mean, I had a lot of fucking fun with you. It was nice to meet you. Anything else you want to say?
I'll be featuring for Tony again in June here in Houston. So
is that true?
We'll see you. Yeah.
Oh, awesome.
Watch what he says. We'll see what happens.
Son Tran, ladies and gentlemen.
Good
there
job,
he goes.
Man.
There you go. That's how it happens. Look at this fucking guy. Spent all day drinking coffee instead of setting up the mics when he should have been. This fucking, good lord.
Do a black guy. I like chanting that.
There he goes, everybody. Geico can save 20% or more on your car insurance. Oh.
Whoa.
I pulled another name out of the bucket. Oh, shit. This guy actually got up last night. Let's see if he has a second minute. He traveled all the way from Austin, Texas for this. Actually, he traveled all the way from fucking Kansas, we found out, to Austin, and now has driven from Austin to fucking Houston for this. 20-hour drive from Kansas to here. Put your hands together for Trey Thompson, everybody.
Congratulations, ladies. I am single and straight, despite looking like the tallest bottom you've ever seen. I got turned down for a janitor position, and I'm super bummed about it. You might ask Trey, why does that bum you out? What's worse than being a janitor? Being told you're not qualified enough to be a janitor cuts just a little bit deeper. I knew my ex was a psychopath when she told me she was sexually attracted to me. If you're not laughing at that, that means you think I'm sexually attractive and I will be here after the show. She wasn't all flaws, though. She had kind of an oversized nose, and she would do this adorable thing where she would wiggle it every time she'd fuck my best friend behind my back. True story, your laughter helps with the healing process. I love bad bitches. That's my fucking problem. Thank you so much. My name is Trey Thompson.
Trey Thompson, ladies and gentlemen. Holy fucking shit.
Tight.
That was awesome, dude.
Tight.
Thank you.
Those jeans are tight. Oof, fuck me. How'd you get those on your body anyway?
You look like a grown-up version of everything Oshkosh Bagosh right now. I mean, you look like a doll that you would play with. Wowzers. I mean, what is this attire?
You are proof that there is no such thing as gender.
You look like you were a little boy who went to a carnival and wished to be a big whatever the fuck you want. Sure. Whatever you want, Zoltaire. Have fun.
This guy looks like he has a permanent ride on the magic school bus.
By the way, both of these guys so far, we haven't even touched on their comedy because they're both fucking really good comics. We haven't shit on them at all.
Really good comics.
But you're both hilarious to make fun of the way you look, so
thank you.
Take that as a compliment.
Really good comics. Trey's a hustler, and as you can tell by the way he's dressed, before this he performed at a Build-A-Bear, so... The fuck is? I feel like you've had that shirt for like 15 years, and you just love it because there's
Old
like
Navy. It's only the people that sell tall clothes.
He looks like he teaches a skateboarding class
to kids that already know how to skateboard. Wow, Trey, you giant fucking baby. What I love about this is we've just been bashing him, and his whole set was like, oh, no, so cool, I'm free, ladies, what's up? And then all of a sudden, now all those same ladies that thought you were cool are like, oh, my God, he is dressed like a dork.
Do you date a lot? I mean, do you have a lot of girls in your life?
Not really, no.
I think that's the whole joke, guys.
Well, what was the last girl?
Yeah.
He's horrific looking. Nobody's fucking him. That's the idea. Did you guys really miss that point of this?
You're only into black chicks, right?
I mean, I'm not opposed to them.
What are you...
You're not a Texan.
I haven't found one that's into me yet.
Leave.
What was your
have
last
you ever, girl? Have you ever been with a black woman?
No.
Right. So.
It's delicious.
Are you only autistic when you're getting dressed? I mean, all the way down to those, like, shoes that look like shoes that shouldn't have laces but Velcro straps instead. It looks like there should be 3 Velcro straps there. How old are you, Trey?
24.
24. What do you do for fun when you're not doing stand-up?
I
cut myself.
I just do stand-up. listen to podcasts and do stand-up.
Other than listening to podcasts and doing stand-up, what do you do to get away from that sometimes?
Video games, just a bunch of boring
What video
shit.
Games?
Battlefield.
Yeah, it looks like it.
We know he doesn't work out.
Right. I'm going to start here soon.
No.
That's a really weird thing to respond to that with.
You don't
This guy looks like he doesn't work out. I'm about to.
Any day now.
Back off.
You have the body of a guy that's put the words gym on a calendar many times, but have never actually gone.
And it was another man's name. I'm going to fuck gym on Wednesday.
You're built like you've never gone to the gym, but like you stretch continuously. Wow. Sometimes even I surprise myself. That was fucking hot. Wow. Oh, man. How do I follow that? You got up last night. Maybe we should just keep flying through. Anything else you want to say, Trey? You live in your dreams?
Yeah, this is fun. I got up twice, and I drove 12 hours for it, so it's worth it.
12 hours. Awesome. Anything else with Trey, guys? Any thoughts or anything?
Dude, genuinely really fucking funny shit.
Yeah. And also, you know what I like? It was, or maybe I don't know this, but his act didn't seem, like after talking to him afterwards now, this is who he was in his act, which is fucking really great.
I came up, and you were like, oh, you're doing this character where you're some fucking weirdo.
Yeah.
And then you talk to him, and you're like, okay. Oh.
I'd even say... I'd even give you a note and say you could even go a little bit slower. Take your time a little more.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I felt like you were even going a little, even though it's a whole, I got to do it in the minute thing. It's like always the biggest note is like take your time during this because it's not about how many jokes you do. It's about us fucking feeling whatever, your weird child man energy. There he goes, Trey Thompson, ladies and gentlemen. Boom, another one. We're having fun so far. We're meeting human beings. He's on Twitter at Tall and Oates. Whoa. Damn, Jeremiah laying it down over there. He's feeling it. He's in the zone.
The vagina.
No reservations over there by this Indian fellow. Shut up.
Please don't make that catch on.
We don't want it to catch on, so stop doing it. Still the same idiot that said that he heard the cat, by the way. The same guy chanting Jerry is the only guy that heard the cat.
It was recorded on an MP3, so you're going to be able to hear it.
Oh, I wonder who the guy that goes in and fixes the levels before the podcast gets releases. You fucking bullshitter.
We can listen to it immediately after the show.
Nobody heard the cat. That's all that matters. If the comedian can't hear the cat, it's not about the podcast. You're going to make Sun Tran look like an idiot on the podcast. Wow! The cat's just, wow! Meow!
Maybe Brian's girlfriend was getting into so many car accidents because he was working on her car.
I can only push the button. That's all I can tell you.
I don't know why you're so defensive about it. We know.
Because I pushed it 4 fucking times. What the fuck do you think I'm talking about?
Defensive and then
Jesus
really
Christ.
Defensive.
Do you not hear what I'm saying?
But if we can't hear it in the room, okay.
God damn. Yeah, it's not me.
Then turn the... I'm looking at the...
Oh, light. Wait the fuck up!
I don't know why you're
I don't have it. Anything other than have this little knob.
It's turned all the fucking way up. But it's not.
Jesus Christ.
I don't know why you're yelling, because it's definitely not...
Because I'm sick of your shit, man!
Are you serious?
No.
Oh, perfect. But I'm just saying, in the future...
And the Academy Award for Best Podcast Performance.
I think there was a little bit of truth in there. I think it came from a real place, but he's still red band.
Not to pour gas on the fire, but I did hear the kitty once or twice.
Yes!
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah. He did!
No, you heard the wolf on your t-shirt, you piece of shit. Can I have a Crown Royal and Coke at some point, by the way?
And can I get a Jack and Diet?
You guys want a drink?
Yeah, can I get another
shot of Fireball?
IPA, what do you want? Two shots? Oh, wait, no, you don't. No, Zarka for Louis J.
Some water and
cocaine, please. Your
finest
Zarka.
Could I get some white man fire water, please?
I pulled another name out of the bucket. You guys ready for more? Uninterrupted 60 seconds going to Zane Fletcher. Zane Fletcher. Oh, wait, is he coming from the middle of the room all the way around?
No, music.
Zane's taking the long path.
Music.
Oh, no music now.
Music.
Hey, put your hands together for Zane Fletcher, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, what's up, y'all? So, I have a friend who's like a weed head trying to pass a drug test. No dice, let me tell ya. He had this fucking, this Visine bottle that he filled with like coffee grounds and water that he strained or some shit, put some pineapple juice in there. I mean, I guess it should work, but, so, he figured he had to get it up to temperature for the drug test, right? Because it's got to be body temperature. But he put it in the microwave at this gas station right by the drug testing place. And we were smoking weed on the way to the drug testing place. So it's like, Jesus Christ. And so I was like, dude, put it in there for like 20 seconds. This motherfucker puts it in there for 2 minutes. Okay? He gets it out there, it's like engorged, like Zeus's cock. It's like fucking scary. It's like this fucking fat. Meow. Right?
Okay, there you go. That was a that was the cat.
Hey, Brian, could you turn that cat down a little bit?
Zane, you were absolutely hilarious. Your comedy was terrible. Let's talk about it. How long you been on stand-up for?
This is my first time.
Wow, there you go. In that case, it was pretty amazing.
That wasn't that bad.
I swear to God, I would have thought it was his third. And that's crazy. That's crazy.
I'm sorry to all the real comedians that wanted to get
shut up, Zane. Getting back.
Yeah,
in
none
front
of these people are real comedians.
Get back in front of the mic.
They live in Houston.
I like your. I like your style, Zane. I love it. You look like a guy that wants to be a school shooter, so he dresses up. So he dresses up as one of the students to try to like sneak in. He tries to like go undercover, just a seventh grader.
Shit. He looks like someone from a different species who was sent here to try to dress like humans. And they're like, what would a human wear? I don't know. Probably one. Like, he saw one movie in the 80s and he just has to go off that. He's like this.
Yes.
I want to congratulate him on winning the Olympics in Mighty Ducks 2.
Oh, this is so much fun. Zane,
what made you want to do stand-up? What was the thing?
Well, to be honest, like, I've always wanted to do it, and, like, I listened to the podcast, so I was like, if I get a chance to, like, for this to be my first time, I'd be here.
Yeah, we've popped a lot of people's cherries. And
we've let them do the show, too.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Zane, why are you dressed like you're a caddy at a putt-putt course?
I mean, shit.
Isn't he just like Marty McFly from the future where he didn't fit into his clothes?
How did you make the last guy look like a good dresser?
I'm a fucking great dresser. This is a nice jacket, great t-shirt.
Interesting. So, Zane, what do you do for work?
Woo!
How old are you? By the way, what are you, Ric Flair?
Woo!
All right.
What do? I'm styling and profiling, Tony.
I don't know if he is. Zane, what do you do for work?
I have been like unemployed for like 2 months.
Wow, why did you just turn gay?
It's raining, man! Boom, hallelujah!
I've been unemployed for like fucking just 2 months.
So I'll suck your dick for $12.
You got so gay there,
Zane. As soon as you mention money, he goes into gay hooker mode.
Oh, music's back up. Look at this. This is perfect.
All right, thank you.
All right, Zane, I have a lot to find out about you. Let's talk about it.
Oh, shit.
How old are you?
I'm 26. I turned 26 last month.
About to turn 27.
No, I turned 26 last month.
Okay, just say fucking 26, dude. I turned 26 last month. I turned 27 in 11 months.
I'm 26 in 1/4.
In 13 months. Fuck that up? Yeah, I did. 23 months. Motherfucking haters. I'll get tweets about that. You idiot. You idiot, Tony. Your math was way off. Cheers.
Cheers. Thanks, Ashley.
Cheers to you guys. Okay, Zane. Let's get into it, buddy. What was the last job that you had? 2 months ago.
I was an auto detailer.
Answer the question, Zane.
What's the answer?
Just straight to the answer.
He was a DJ.
A DJ.
I was a dropping those frat beats.
So Zane, what was this occupation that you had?
I did interior.
Why do you always have to set it up? Why can't you just say the
job?
Say the word.
I was once a
DJ Dry Dick.
Wow, that was a good impression,
dude,
Indian
hold on,
man.
Just for a second, try it with me. Ask me what my job is.
What's your job?
Comedian.
All right, your turn. Let's try it. Zane, what was the last job that you had?
Detailer.
What was it?
Well, all right, now it's too little.
I was an auto detailer. Like, I would do interior repairs on
you
cars.
You mean you're the
you
one
left that, one you, of the words off?
I fixed that guy's car.
You're the one that's fucking Sun Tran's wife? Very hard to do an auto detailer callback on an improvised show. Let it be known, you don't find that anywhere in entertainment.
It's high level, Tony.
That was a high level callback.
We're just playing. We're all the Yankees tonight. We're all just hitting home runs. Back to you, Zane.
You like manga? You like anime?
I like anime.
I love anime.
I'm not like a fucking super animated. Though.
Are you about to
oh,
fucking
you know
judge?
What that means? I don't have my ceilings covered in posters.
Did you really just throw me a, I like anime. I'm not one of those anime nerds, but like just as much as the next guy, sure. I jerk off to the stuff. I mean.
What is your favorite type of porn, Zane?
My favorite type of porn? To tell you the truth, lately it's been just regular meat and potato shit. You know, just girls
how
are
do you
attractive.
That's the funniest thing you've ever... That, please put in your act.
What did
you
he
like
say?
Meat and potatoes porn.
I can't understand anything this fucking guy says. I don't know how you guys know what he's saying. He has worse English than Sun Tran's entire family.
Did you say, like, meat and potatoes porn?
Yes.
Like Irish porn?
Wait, baked potatoes porn?
Bangers and mash.
I'm really into corned beef and cabbage porn. Yeah. That's my shit.
What the fuck was your answer, Zane?
Meat and potatoes.
I've never wanted to give a guy a dry erase board before to answer questions on a live podcast.
It's like regular porn, you know?
Are you a white guy?
No, meat and potatoes is tranny porn. Dicks and fake tits. Yeah.
Wait, is that true?
I don't know if it's true, but it should be. Like, that should be what they call.
Yeah, meat potatoes. Double D's and then a long 7-inch dick.
Anyway, what was the actual answer to the question that I asked you, Zane?
Meat and
like
potatoes.
Regular porn, man. Just like chicks that find attractive.
Chicks that are attractive?
Who do you find attractive? Who's your favorite porn star? Great question.
I mean, I don't know, dude.
You fucking know, Zane.
The ones I can think of are like ones I don't like, strangely enough.
Ask me the same question.
What's your favorite porn
Sasha
star?
Sasha Grey.
All right.
Before you finish the question.
Yeah, and she's retired. That's how good she is. I don't even need the new shit. I can watch the old shit and still jerk off to it.
I'll fuck her wearing
she's
a Michael
super
Jordan
retired. She's
no, no cream pies on record. Unbelievable. Can still come to her. That's how good she is.
Is that a real thing? She has
no cream pies.
Zane, I'm not gonna lie. You sort of seem like a creepy guy to me. So with that said, let me ask you this. What do you think? Let's get to the point here. What do you think in your real life? You know everything about you. And we know that you're a cool dude. You smoke a lot of pot. You're pretty hip. You know, you look like Josh Martin if he gave up. Which is funny because Josh Martin already looks like he gave up. But let me ask this question. What do you think, if you had to guess, without trying to be funny, just tell the truth, but what's, like, the weirdest thing about you?
The weirdest thing about me?
There's the Zane Fletcher setup that we all know and love.
Are you doing the weirdest stance about you?
Yeah. The weirdest thing about me is I'm a gay superhero. I don't even know what you're playing.
Whenever he thinks, he turns into a homosexual.
Let me answer your question. What's the weirdest thing about you, Zane? So, I know you're at number like 117 in your Rolodex of weird. Can't say that one. I can't tell them that. This is a live podcast. Fuck.
What is the weirdest thing about me? You tell me, man. I hang around weird people. It's hard for me to tell like the weirdest thing about me.
I mean, I can name like 400 things.
Like,
come on, throw something out there. Tell us something that you don't want people to know about you.
That I don't want people to know about me.
All right, Zane, I'm going to ask you a question. Okay, hold on a second here. Can we pause that for a second? I need to get serious here. I'm going to ask you a question, all right? I want you to already have the microphone next to your mouth. Stop doing that fucking boring Anthony Jeselnik thing that you keep doing by dropping the mic near your waist. I'm not saying Jeselnik's boring. I'm saying he's a boring version of Anthony Jeselnik. Let's just get that clear. I love Anthony Jeselnik. No, not at all. Multiple time guest on this show. Love Anthony. You're a boring version of Anthony Jeselnik. When you drop, keep the mic right next to your mouth. You ready? Keep it next
to
your mouth. Don't move it from there. I'm about to ask you a question. With no reset, I need you to answer it immediately without thinking. You can do no wrong. Ready? What's your least favorite race?
Oh my God.
Answer it! Say it!
The white man.
Zane, every second that you wait, you're losing. All right,
once again, ask me the same question. Jews!
Obviously it's Jews, you idiot. It's always Jews.
Let's try it again. Zane, you totally failed at the one fucking mission, by the way. Stop putting the mic. Is your dick about to do stand-up? Put the mic up next to your mouth. Put it next to your fucking mouth.
He's doing this, like, shuffle thing, too. Like, he dances up there. It's great.
Jeremiah is hating this right now.
It's time to move on. We need more comics up here.
I agree. I'm sorry. True. I'm trying to get Zane to have a breakthrough, and I don't think it's going to happen. You're not answering the questions at all, but it's okay. You're not used to this.
Well, you guys, like, get your bits in, like, before I have time to answer. It's, like, hard to think of, like,
what's
the weirdest thing about
shit,
that I don't want people to know.
You seem like a rapper. Wow. Look what's finally happening. Look who's coming out of his, No, I'm kidding. Zane, put the mic back in.
The weirdest thing about me is, like, I listen to your podcast probably.
No, you're wrong about that. Oh. Way to play to the crowd of people that came to the show that you're on right now.
The weirdest thing about me is
I listen to this bullshit.
Only a bunch, Zane.
Only a bunch
of idiots would listen to this podcast.
Yeah. I'm glad we gave you 12 and a half minutes to think of an answer, and that's what you came up with.
I hope this crowd beats the shit out of you after the show. I swear to God, I hope they stomp the fucking shit out of you and take your jacket off your body and wave it over their head. Look, they're fucking getting rowdy right now. They're throwing bottles.
Hey, man.
Zane, before I let you go, I do want to say this, is that it needs to absolutely be remembered that anybody who ever wants to do this should absolutely feel free to always sign up. It's something that you wanted to do, and you had fun, and it was fun getting to meet you, and you're different, and thank you for doing it. There he goes, Zane Fletcher, everybody.
Thanks.
It's fun to take chances and do different shit. Out of all the people that we've ever had on, though, I think he has some deep, dark secrets, that kid. Oh, what's the weirdest thing about me? He's just picturing this girl that's tied up right now behind his parents' shed. Weirdest thing about me? Oh, I don't even know what could be. Maybe the show?
She's going to be brisket later.
I pulled another name out of the bucket. Anything can happen, as we've learned. Put your hands together for Gabe Bravo. Whoa, he got a big pop. It's a local hero. I said I'm free to do what I
I've only got a minute, so shut up. I cut my girlfriend's cocaine with Valtrex because we have herpes and she doesn't need to know about it just yet.
It's a good idea.
Thank you. When I was a kid, my mom would drive me to school every day, which was very nice of her. The only thing I had against that was I never got to see the inside of a public school bus, so I didn't know what that was all about. I knew what the short buses were for, but that just made me terrified that the regular buses were for giant retarded people. People have told me I have a golden penis. It's not because of my sexual prowess. It's because my Uncle Midas was a very bad man.
Good job.
Listen to that. Gabe Bravo, ladies and gentlemen.
That's me.
I believe it was the great Louis J. Gomez that once said the words, tight. Tight.
Also tight.
That was from his first book.
Everything about that was absolutely unbelievable, Gabe.
Great.
Great jokes. How long have you been doing stand-up?
About 4 years.
Yeah, it feels like even more than that. Your jokes are beyond their years.
Really good for 4 years.
Yeah, that Valtrex joke was not only a great joke, but also a great idea.
Yeah, I feel like...
I wrote that down. You know what's weird?
The last guy apologized to the real comedians, but he couldn't have made you look better. So he really...
It's true. That's true.
I feel like this is a weird compliment that I don't think I've ever given anyone, but I can like picture all the funniest comedians that I know laughing at that Valtrex joke.
Oh, thank you.
That seems so smart to me. Lewis even turned to me, and we're fucking at the top of Hater Mountain, if you're ever wondering. And he turned to me and said, "That's
compliments.
A great joke." And I mean,
Valtrex burns, though. I notice it always burns.
Burns.
That's the thing. I know a friend who has it prescribed to him, and it's very like the pills are huge. Like I wanted to take a look at
what's
them.
What's this friend's name?
Steven Brando. He's the owner of this club.
Oh, just got called out.
Oh, that's fucking hilarious.
Yeah, that Florida. Backfired, motherfucker.
Wow.
Got him.
Talk about being thrown under the bus.
Only a white man would turn on his brother like that.
Holy shit. Oh my God. Oh, they're going to change the fucking chant, you buffoon.
Yeah, what the fuck?
What? This guy's the worst. All right. Well, Gabe, I mean, you're fucking unbelievable. Are you here in Houston?
Yeah.
Why? What are you doing? What's going on?
It's cheap to live here. I tour with a couple of guys. I've done a bunch of shows with Todd Barry. I do stuff with... I went on a little run with Joe DeRosa, who I like that guy a lot. Mm. I'm about to go on tour.
Did you borrow those clothes from him?
I don't have a lot of clothing options. I lost a bunch of weight.
You got the pants from Todd Barry and the shirt from Joe DeRosa. For those of you that don't know, you have to, I guess, Google image those punchlines.
I mean, you can literally, if you did the bottom of Todd's body and the top of Joe's body, that would be exactly that.
We forgot to mention that whoever's the best, we think is the best comedian of the night, gets to open the next show.
The stand-up show.
You're definitely high on the list right now.
There you go.
Well, thank you. It's very nice of you.
If you can.
Unfortunately, he only has a minute, so if you don't like the same jokes, you're not...
Do we decide, or does the audience decide who goes to the
end? Yeah, audience will decide. Yeah.
Wow, okay. No, just because he said audience, I want to decide.
But we can veto it.
Shut up. Will you please shut up for the rest of the show? Can you completely? Yeah, you're so annoying.
I had to remove so many people at the festival, and I'll do it to you. I don't give a shit.
He yells again, I want him gone. Thank you. That's how it happens.
Too much sexual tension.
That's not only do we want him gone.
That's what it is. I totally want to fuck that guy.
We want his head to hit every door on the way out.
Gabe, what else about you? What's your real life like?
Do you have a podcast?
I don't have a podcast.
You make money?
I'm a musician and a comedian, and I work here.
Wow, you sing?
No, I play drums.
That is so fucking cool.
On your stomach?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's called Hambone.
Are you in a band?
Kind of. I play with a guy named Dylan Trim. He's a very talented singer.
Oh, cool.
Really? Whoa, well, where were you fucking yesterday, idiots?
Wow.
Fuck you. Come support
me. Wait. Let me just tell you something. Only 3 people clapped at that.
Yeah.
So how small was your audience last night?
Oh, my God. It was
where
tiny.
Where were you 3 people? There you go.
It was embarrassing. We have
some footage of Gabe playing. What's the name of your band?
I play with Dylan Trim.
Dylan Trim.
So the band is called Dylan Trim and Gabe Bravo.
Oh, that's awesome. That's
original. Wait, is this a drummer and a singer?
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
You guys like killing it?
I wanted to hate that, but then I started thinking about it. I was like, that sounds pretty cool.
Do you love that?
I like it, yeah. I've been playing with that guy for a long time.
What's your stand-up to music ratio, thought-wise, like in a day? Not how many hours, but like percentage-wise, like if it was 100% pie.
Stand-up is like probably 90%.
Yeah.
And then music is like maybe 9%.
So if you could...
What's that other 1%?
Like high level, like if you wanted, your dream is one over the other, like you'd rather be a comedian?
I want to try to do both at the same time.
No, you got to choose one, dude. You got to pick a fucking lane. You got to pick a path right now. Tonight's the night.
Yeah, no one's ever been like, have you heard Chappelle?
Here, bring out Dylan Trim. Like, bring out
here?
Dylan Trim right now. We're going to bring him up on the stage. We're going to put a fucking gun against his head.
So I can only pick one? What are you trying to...
No. Dude, Jeremiah. No one does music and comedy. Oh, you know what? Actually, it works out pretty good.
Yeah, think about how bad that would be. That'd be awful.
Gabe, what else are you into? You in love?
No, not at all.
You single?
Single, yeah.
How long have you been single for?
Ooh, how long have I been single for?
Are you gay or are you just super hip?
I'm just super hip.
Super hip. I'm the same way. Ooh. I get it all the time. Later on, we can talk about it and totally not make out.
Bonding moment.
No, Tony, he's not super hip. He's got super hips. That's how he keeps those pants up.
You do, but the hip and hipster, Gabe. Yeah.
Thank you.
That's lovely. What kind of pens are those in your pocket?
I think, what kind of pens? These are Bic pens, I think.
Bic?
Whoa.
Bic guy, huh?
Yeah. Ah. They were here. I stole them from here. So,
old school.
Are you looking
more
to...
Pilot, kind of.
Are you looking to purchase any new dream catchers?
Do you have 2 pens because you're a douchebag and you gotta let people know you're a drummer?
Yeah.
Take them out all the time?
That's it. No, these are actually Sun Chan's chopsticks. I tried it. It didn't work.
Well, Gabe, you
sorry,
were...
Sorry, son. I'm so sorry, Sun Tran.
Absolutely so fucking funny with your minute tonight.
Thank you.
You should be extremely proud of yourself. There he goes, Gabe Bravo. He's on Twitter at the Gabe Bravo. What was that? Why?
He was going crazy over there. I'm sorry, I just did 2 fireballs.
Just relax then. I pulled another name out of the bucket. Put your hands together for Gavin Burr.
What's up? Works now, don't it? Thank you. I have this theory that veganism and CrossFit are spreading the same way Christianity used to. Just a bunch of white people moved in and then never shut the fuck up. It's like, you guys want to try this thing we're into? It's got a lot of rules. Got fancy places where just us hang out. It's great. It's really the way you ought to be. Yeah. Anyway. I was raised Catholic. Yeah, it was terrible. But a good point is, I don't even know where I was fucking going with that.
Neither did we.
Gavin Burr. Go.
What up?
All right. For those of you listening to the podcast, it was we were surprised to see that Gavin Burr, we pulled the name out of the bucket, and that was the sound tech that's been fixing everything that has gone wrong throughout the night. The
multiple things. I'll be fired tomorrow.
You shouldn't have fixed anything.
I don't think they were going to fire you up until the set that they just saw you do.
Yeah.
Now they're probably going to fire
you. If only you could go back in time and not fix your mic.
Yeah. I would totally do that.
No.
That's a good point.
It wasn't...
It's not your fault. It's the cables. Like, you guys buy the shittiest cables ever, I guess.
Well, fucking four-in-one show.
Four-in-one show.
It was the great Alanis Morissette that once said, "You live, you learn."
Yeah.
It's called "You Live, You Learn." He just leaned into me and goes, "What song is that?" What the fuck happened to you?
I thought it was just a lyric, Tony!
Oh, this new yelling thing is the worst, by the way. If this is your way to... All right, fuck it. Gavin, let's talk about it. You work here.
Yeah. Yeah.
How long have you worked here?
6 months since we opened.
Oh, wow. It's only been open 6 months.
Yeah.
Well, then we're here. We've sold this place out twice in 6 months. How about that? That's crazy. Somehow Houston has become like the Tower 7 of Kiltony.
It's always.
It's just our little brother to the east.
Black helicopters.
Gavin, okay, let's just try to jump into it. How have you done? You do stand up?
Yeah.
Oh, well, in that case, whoopsie daisy.
Gavin, put down the mic stand. Don't hit us.
How long you been doing it?
About a year.
Awesome.
Okay.
Also, I do have like legitimate like crippling fucking anxiety, so I've already been like cursing myself for this fuck up that y'all have experienced.
Let me say, because you even mentioned when I think when the first guy was up, like you were like, oh, you were very poised up here. I just say, dude, for a year in comedy, when I was a year in comedy, I was still nervous to do comedy, and to do comedy with comics who have been doing comedy judging for that to be anxiety provoking is like. Very normal. Like that makes
especially
sense.
Especially
so
when
it's not like a thing that's weird.
Well, here's the thing. Dave is trying to work here again. I don't really care. He's lying right to your face. That was horrific.
Dude, I was.
It needs to be said. It needs to be said.
Gavin, the anxiety never, ever, ever goes away.
Oh yeah,
by
no,
the
it
way.
hasn't remotely come close to stopping.
What?
I said it hasn't come remotely close to stopping.
Well, I mean, that's a different conversation. What I'm talking about is the anxiety. Don't do anything crazy. And if you do happen to kill yourself tonight, do it by these janky cables that you bought for the show.
Yeah.
You can hang yourself.
I promise.
No, I'm kidding.
Are you also a musician? Because you have that musician look.
No, not currently.
No? Yeah, so you have nothing else.
No,
to
I tried
back.
To get laid when I was younger. So yeah.
You like? I feel like you're maybe more of a roadie. You. Favorite band?
I just do whatever Andrew tells me to do.
I need you
to suck my
dick.
I just do whatever Andrew tells me to do. What are you, the Gimp? God.
Yeah.
Bring out the Gimp.
Oh, shit.
He does make me wear the suit.
Does he beat you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Interesting. Gavin, what's your life like? I mean, what do you do on a day-to-day basis? Go ahead, Gavin.
Waste time until I fucking come here and spend 18 hours a day here.
And then what do you mostly do here? Just run around fixing shit that could have taken care of before?
Yeah.
All right.
See, I did sound check every item on this stage.
Yeah, we did.
And it was great.
We did. That's true. It's true.
But didn't make it to the start.
What are you beating yourself up more about, the set or the sound check?
The sound check, clearly.
Really, the sound check.
Andrew's gonna be very mad at me.
I'm a bad boy.
Andrew doesn't like it when we make mistakes.
When you were born at the hospital and your mother wrote Gavin on your birth certificate, did they give you the complimentary beanie?
Yeah. Well, I only have enough hair to stick out the back.
Okie dokie. Yeah.
That got dark for no reason.
Beanie.
It's so weird. Even though you didn't take it off, I can see it now. Like, I see it.
No, see, like, I have Jack Nicholson's hairline, no joke, so that's why I always wear hats and shit.
Why? Oh.
You have a girlfriend?
Huh?
You have a girlfriend?
Yeah.
Put the hat back on.
Wow, your hair.
That was like, he went from fucking, I don't know why, with he looks like kind of a hip dude with the hat on, then he takes it off, you're like, okay, this guy rapes and murders people.
Like hat on, people kind of want to fuck me. Hat on, no.
No, not at all.
You look like the disowned son of Jesus Christ.
Funny story.
I am a disowned son.
Oh, now you're going to start?
Yeah. All right.
Oh, here's a bunch of funny jokes I could tell you.
I remember now.
Well, it's not really a joke. It's just...
Speaking of
entertaining,
Jesus' disowned son, like, fuck you, Dad. Grandpa runs everything anyway.
No, but,
yes. Yes. It was a good joke, Tony.
Thank you very much. I'm just soaking in it, even though nobody's really laughing as hard as what it deserved. I'm picturing the laughs it deserved. That's what I do now. Instead of getting mad at the crowd, I just hear the laughs that it deserved. I hear it in my own head.
They say Beethoven heard the music before he wrote it.
That's it. That's how I do it. Gavin, what was your funny story? I said you look like the son that Jesus disowned, and you said...
Yeah, yeah. So about 31 years ago...
Whoa.
My mom was fucking around on my dad. And
she was
Jesus
like the Mary
Christ
Magdalene.
Superstar just so happened to be on tour, and she was sleeping with Teddy, the dude playing Jesus.
I love how his name was Teddy. Guy named Teddy was fucking your mom. That's awesome.
Yeah. And I do look more like him than my dad, so.
So you're telling me that in this crazy world where I nailed a 10-star joke about you being Jesus' disowned son, you're telling me right now
there's a shred
that
of truth.
Your mother cheating on your father with a guy that made a living playing Jesus Christ, and you're most likely his disowned son?
Holy shit. Tony fucking Hinchcliffe.
Wait, do Tony Hinchcliffe's joke have the power to make things real?
Your jokes are divine intervention, Tony.
I'm changing the world. And Tony, I did it all after a shot of Fireball.
Like, Tony's gonna start performing at churches where he jokes people out of wheelchairs.
Oh my god. Alright, Gavin, you get back to work. We need out there. We're gonna fly through some more people. There he goes. Gavin Burr. Wait a second. Hold on, I just noticed something amazing. Gavin Burr, that's B-U-R-R. Clearly, no relation to Bill Burr. It's really... Jeremiah, are you okay over there?
Today's in a weird place.
My day for saxophone solos in between the show.
It is my favorite motion picture film, Jurassic Park.
I pulled another name out of the bucket. Let's make some noise for Zahid Duji.
Hey, guys. Nice to be here. I love dogs. Not the way Sun likes dogs, just the regular way. I have one of those friends that treats her dog like it's her baby, you know, one of those people. Like, the other day, she drowned it in a tub. I was like, what? Yeah. Silly bitch. That's a ridiculous thing to do. Last week, somebody on the street goes, "What's up, Queery McFagstein?" They just shouted that, and I was like, it's one thing to call me gay, but to imply that I'm an Irish Jew? Real fucked up. Didn't like that. Jews are the worst people. Call back. Just kidding. They're not people. I'm 29. I still live with my parents, which would be totally acceptable if they were still alive or whatever. So, I think the term stillborn is very confusing because it sounds like good news, but in reality, that's just a misconception. So,
Zahid Duji.
Oh, shit. Very impressive. Yes.
I love the most that he was doing so good that in his last 20 seconds of his minute, he got into that comfortable leg pose where he's like, I'm really going to enjoy the stage.
It made me furious.
Yeah. Oh.
I said it to Tony, as soon as his foot went on there, I was liking him, and then I watched it in slow motion.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, who the fuck does this guy think he is?
And, he's doing,
right.
And then Tony goes, ugh, those are feelers.
And then he goes, no, it makes me furious. And I go, no, those are feelers. That's literally what happened.
That was an amazing moment of who I am, who Lewis is, and who you are as a person. I just went, I like it. And Lewis went, I hate it. And Tony goes, those shoes suck.
I was with you. It was more like and they're feelers than just like, ugh.
It's true. Both.
It's very office space.
I've never seen anybody go in 40 seconds from a nobody to Kevin Hart. But, I mean...
Hey, I'll take the comparison.
40 seconds, I got this, bitch. Just start taking
and
off your clothes.
He was kind of nervous at first. His arms were crazy. My first note in my head was his body language was very nervous.
Yeah.
And then he got that first big laugh, and the jokes were good, and you opened the fuck up, but you opened up just a little bit too much.
Did you ever see, what's the guy's name, who was married to Mariah Carey, did Cannon?
Nick Cannon.
Nick Cannon.
He did a special. If you didn't see it, you shouldn't. But he starts off in a suit, and by the end of the hour, he's like in a wife beater and shit. Like he keeps loosening the tie, and then blah blah. You pulled that off in a minute with what you did in that thing. So you're already better than Nick Cannon in my mind.
Hey, I think we all are. All right.
No, he's legitimately a better comedian than Nick Cannon.
Also, by the way, also in that minute, you're also a better stand-up comedian than Nick Cannon.
Oh, thank you.
But to your credit, Zahid, you do sort of look like you were shot out of a Nick Cannon. So. That's true. What is your ethnicity?
Dude, that's not that off. I'm East African Indian, so that is
really?
Pretty fucking accurate right
Did
there.
You say Indian? I can relate to Tony. The only thing I didn't like about your set was your shoes, because they are white.
Oh, fuck. God damn it. Zahid, how long have you been on stand-up? Very, very fun.
Three and a half years.
3.5 years.
I would say he's in the list of the people that we might call to the show
there
afterwards.
There you go. Brian's having this imaginary reality show competition over here tonight. And so your name goes over there with Brian while he keeps doing this. If Simon Cowell gave up 40 years ago thing that he's doing over here.
He's emailing your agent right now. Like, you'll see.
All right, for the rest of the comedians coming up, no, we only have 3 roses left.
Are you all white over there?
What's up with Jeremiah?
Reset him.
Can you hold him? Hit the button
he's,
down.
He's light as a feather, stiff as a board. It's a feather Indian. All right, fuck it.
Great joke, Tony.
I'm already pulling another name out of the bucket while Zahid is on stage, by the way, for those of you paying close attention.
So you're also, I will say right now, for whatever your ethnicity is, kind of like an attractive version of that.
Oh, yeah.
What?
You're the better version of that, definitely. 100%.
Well, actually,
What are East African Indians known for? Are they known for, like, I mean, East African and Indian? Yikes. Am I right?
Better than
people?
Any Vietnamese, though. Am I right, guys?
Yikes. All
right.
Like tech support for D Ant Word.
It's almost like if you're African.
Hey, Red Band finally got a laugh. All right, cool. We're
whoa.
Killing it. Oh, he's doing good. He's doing good.
Shut up.
You fucked up. You fucked up.
I'm taking
you
this fucking up. List oh, over here.
Looks like Gabe Bravo just jumped right back to the top. Yeah. Hard to do in pants as tight yeah. as he's wearing, but he made the jump back up to the top.
Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no,
but seriously, those. Okay, guys. So African and Indian, does that mean that you show up late and you find out you should have made reservations?
Or does it mean you constantly search for chicken on the internet?
Indians go on the internet a lot?
Do you not like the...
The gas station kinds, yes.
Do you not like the Asian guy that was up before? You've taken two shots at him.
No,
already.
I love him, man. I love Son. I love Gabe, Gavin. All the guys up here were all good friends.
Okay.
So, yeah. All
right.
I don't know awesome. The fuck that Zane guy was, though, but everybody else.
I love that. Well, man, we're going to keep flying through people.
Cool,
you absolutely did great
thank
tonight.
You guys
congratulations.
So much. Thanks a lot, man.
Awesome
appreciate
stuff.
It. Good night, guys. Thanks.
There he goes, Zahid Duji. Whoa, Brian just put him back in his magic pile. Brian grabbed a piece of paper and put it back. A storyline to follow later. At the end, Brian sort of liked him. If you're following Brian's side reality show.
Red Band.
What'd I do this time?
Okay. I pulled another name. Are you guys having fun or what? I pulled another name out of the bucket. Another uninterrupted 60 seconds goes to Jake Walker.
Dude.
Here we go. I don't see not much of a walker at all, it seems. He's coming?
Yes.
Oh,
he's blind,
shit.
Tony,
he's blind.
You fucking asshole.
He's going the wrong way.
Help him up.
Somebody fucking help him up.
Oh, take shit. Him to the other
wait,
side.
Wait, it's a, wait. You're going to confuse him or something. Oh, hey, just have him climb
he's
up.
Not he's a black guy. Don't worry.
Yeah. Oh, shit. This is unbelievable.
I'm dropping flavor. My behavior is hereditary. But my technique is very necessary.
That was great entrance.
All right. Yeah, I just had hemorrhoid surgery. Any of y'all deal with that? Yeah, I had a case of what I call hubba bubba butt. That's where your ass looks like somebody chewed up a whole pack of gum at one time and just kind of gave you a hubba bubba butt plug right in there. And they showed me a picture of my ass before the surgery. It looked like every single character from that crazy Star Wars bar scene was sitting with Jabba the Hutt at a poker table shaped like an old balloon knot. When I got home, I spent 2 days ordering in pizza, popping Vicodin, because I'd never heard of OIC, opioid-induced constipation. Yeah, after what I call a come-to-Jesus shit. Yeah, OIC now. Yes, yeah. I went back to the doc. He said, you know, we missed a couple. We're going to have to operate again. I said, Doc, damn, I don't need it to look porn quality. I don't know how he missed two. I think my Star Wars guys did the trick.
These are not the roids you're looking for.
Jake Walker, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that, a standing ovation.
Oh, my God. All the girls are taking
God.
Their tops off.
Holy Whoa. Shit.
They're squeezing their tit milk on your shoes.
People are having orgies in the stands right now.
God, Jeremiah's playing the saxophone with his asshole.
All right. Jake.
There was so much incredible about what we just witnessed.
I couldn't agree more.
Yeah, Jake. For those of you listening to the podcast, we should catch you up. Jake's blind as fuck, obviously, as a stick, blind, which is awesome. He's got a big smile on his face. He's much more comfortable than just the pussy-ass, insecure white people that were on earlier.
Oh, I don't feel so good.
You're up here, you're blind as fuck, you're having fun, smiling ear to ear. You got up on stage, you took the hardest path possible. You came up towards the middle.
Yeah.
And you got up on stage.
Not only that, like a black guy tried to help him on stage. And you could see Jake, like, at first he was like, okay. But then he heard that it was a black guy. He was like, yo, man, you need some help? He was like, no, I got it. I got it.
Well, you understand. Actually,
get off my wallet, young man.
No, it's interesting. There's actually science behind this. If you lose your sight, you can hear race. Because it's just evolution, really.
Yeah.
By the way, it was the most badass blind entrance I've ever seen in my life. The black guy came up and he goes, no, you're going the wrong way because you need the stairs because you're a blind guy. And he was like, I fucking got it. And, it was amazing.
It's true. Guy was just trying to be nice, and the blind guy's like, fuck you, bitch.
I didn't want to owe him reparations.
You, whoa, jeez. My God, I'm just going to turn a blind eye to what you just said.
Thank you, Ashton.
Man, so fun. How long have you been doing stand-up?
Well, I went it my first time here in November on Kill Tony's, And then about 2 months, I've been writing every day and going up. And
it's because it takes him like an entire day to write one letter. He's like,
that's right. You did your first set on this show 6 months ago or whatever.
November,
six,
right?
Yeah. And so, but you just decided to start full time 2 months ago.
Well, it got good to me. So around February, I just started.
Well, I mean, he's sort of good to you. You know what I mean?
Hey, Tony, I have a question.
Yes. Yeah, anyway, so I started writing every day and just coming out every night.
Man.
Wait.
Jeez, now I see what this Indian has with white guys.
He's blind to everybody, but he's only deaf to musical comedians.
Yes, go ahead, Indian man.
I was going to ask him where he went to college. Harvard? Never mind.
U of H. Go Cougs.
Let me take that again.
Indian guy, you had a question. Go ahead.
I was just simply going to ask which college you went to, Harvard or Braille?
Worth the second setup for sure. Totally.
He's worth. Got a concussion.
Jake, you're clearly blind. What are some interesting ways that affects you in your day-to-day life?
This is the weirdest Dr. Phil episode I've ever seen, by the way.
At home, I know where everything is, and if it's light outside, I still see some. I can see about 5 degrees, kind of like looking down that roll from the inside of a paper towel roll.
A little tunnel.
Gotcha.
You see that?
I got Dawid on it.
Does that take up like the whole thing?
What's your favorite category of porn? Bumpy?
Yeah, Braille porn, yeah.
Jesus. Bumpy. Bumpy. I like man.
So you guys sit there and go, oh my, oh you whore. Oh my God.
Dirty slut.
Oh, shit. All right, Jake. Well, I mean, what else goes on in your life? You in love?
I am not. I'm doing a little dating, seeing an ex, and...
Well, I mean, you're sort of seeing an ex.
He's a joker, this one. He doesn't say... He's never off.
Where do you meet these dates? Plenty of fish in the can't see?
Oh, come on. That
Braille
was
right, bad. One of the gals I see lives in my condominium complex, and the other is kind of an ex that I dated when I was much younger.
He uses the gay dating app Blinder.
Okay, Jake, we are going to hustle you off, and we're going to get one more human being up here. Jake
right
Walker,
on.
Ladies and gentlemen. We have enough time for one more. You guys want to go to the bucket one more time?
Oh.
Jake, please be careful.
Yeah.
I hope this guy cartwheels out of here.
If he falls and hurts himself, we can't have a lawsuit, so we're just going to all kill him and bury him in the back. So they have a nice big parking lot in the back. Nobody will ever find. Andrew will be mad at us for this.
Oh, so mad.
I pulled another name out of the bucket. Your final comedian of the night. We got to hustle right through it. His name is Tim Keaton. Whoa, right from the middle of the room. Oh, he's taking the blind guy approach. Make some noise for Tim Keaton, everybody. Come on.
Thank you, thank you. This is my first time doing stand-up comedy again. And, well, it's my first time doing stand-up comedy, and unlike my first time in sex, I do hope I last the 60 seconds. So, my mom used to whoop me as a child. I used to get spankings. I was a bad kid. And just like any other Christian lady, she would go straight to the kitchen, grab the first wooden spoon that she could see, and just whack the shit out of me, right? That's fine, but, you know, later on at dinner time when, you know, dad's sipping, so who got their ass whooped today? Tim, was that, I'm tasting some ass beads, like, that's all I got, man, that's,
49 seconds of thunder from Tim Keaton. This definitely seemed like it was your first time comedianing.
Yeah.
Out of all
comedianing is one of the hardest things that you can do.
And we've dealt with a lot of comedianing. And on this podcast in particular, it's comedians comedianing, talking to comedians that are also comedianing for a living.
You know, actually, one of my favorite web series is Jerry Seinfeld's Comedians, Comedians, and Cars Getting Comedians. It's unbelievable.
I'm going to have to catch that.
Yeah. I love it. Tim, have you ever thought that maybe your words would come out better if your blood wasn't being constricted in your arms by that shirt? You are a big, big Texas boy. There's no reason There's no reason you and I should be wearing the same size shirt right now.
No, I used a little too much starch there.
Wait, what? No. Wow. No. Or you're wearing too small of a shirt is the answer. It has nothing to do with starch.
His pistols are too big. That's why.
My pistols?
What is going on over here? His pistols are too big. You are turning into a full-grown bear. You're turning into the West Hollywood bear, bro.
Dude, for your first time.
Fucking pistols. Rawr!
It's a Dallas bear. It's a Dallas bear, Tone. For your first time, that was amazing. I mean, like you can't have a better set than that. Like, that was congratulations for your first time.
Yeah. Thank you. Totally.
Thank you.
It was fun.
It's a bit of a stretch.
To the Indian guy. Go ahead.
No, that shirt is a bit of a stretch right now, I'm saying. Here's the thing. Here's what I'll tell you about this guy. Number one, love the arms. Fucking dope, bro. Second of all, okay? Just got to get that out of the way. I can tell you're like you're one of the funny guys in your friends, right?
More made fun of than
more made fun
guy,
of. Okay. Well, maybe you shouldn't.
But no, in a fun way. Don't awe it. It's a good time. We have fun. Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm saying you seem like you have like a jolly
way
energy.
Way to make it sad, by the way. Yeah. It was like you seem like the funny guy in your friends. Just I don't have friends. What are friends?
Tim, what do for work?
I work for an engineering firm.
Oh, engineering what? Big biceps?
Oh, yeah.
Before what I don't like is that I just can't get a gauge of him. Like, I don't know what this is. Like, you look like you're part of, like, a progressive hate group or something. Like, I don't know. Like,
you don't recognize him? He was the villain in the 80s movie Over the Top.
It's an arm wrestling movie reference for those of you that missed it.
Google it and you'll love it later.
I will say that Indian Jeremiah was trying to get that joke off for 5 full minutes.
Tim Keaton, I've always wondered what it would be like if Mark Hunt did comedy. And I think you pulled it off. We got to hustle out of here, though. There he goes, Tim Keaton. Guys, guess what?
Hey, Tony, who should we pick? Who should we pick for the show next? We got Gabe and Zahid.
Gabe Bravo and Zahid. Who do you guys think?
Who do you guys? Let's Harry, in the count of three, who thinks Gabe?
All right. Okay. Who thinks Zahid? La 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 la. There you go. We catch Gabe Bravo
Gabe,
on the,
you're up. You get to open the show next.
Anyway, So you could be on the lookout for that for those of you coming to the amazing fucking stand-up show that is featuring sets by every single fucking person on this stage tonight and also many other fun secret guests. Also, some of our absolute favorite human beings from the Comedy Store that we work with every night. The great Josh Martin is going to be performing. Lucas Hurl. After this, in between this and all night, Josh Martin has his hands on the brand new... You guys are literally the first to ever get the chance to buy them in the flesh. I haven't even seen them. Look
there
at this.
Is.
The brand new Kill Tony poster. Stand up in the front of the stage, Josh. Josh pretends like he's blind sometimes, too. That's the new poster, so that's for sale all night long. And Jeremiah, what do you want to plug real quick? Anything else for the podcast listeners?
I just discovered social media. Follow. Follow me at Jeremiah Standup. If you reach out to me, I might just hit you back. And I'm on Big J Okerson's new CISO show, What's Your Effin' Deal?
Yeah.
Check it out.
As am I. Keep an eye on that. So check me out on that as well. That's a Kill Tony double up. Dave Smith, thank you so fucking much. This was so fun. Dave Smith's first time as a Kill Tony panelist.
Thank you, dude. I love this show forever. I'm a fan awesome. Of all you guys, so it's great to be here. And just check out Legion of Skanks, follow me on social media and all that.
Listen to Legion of Skanks religiously with the also, of course, as we all know, the Stymaster on my episode of Legion of Skanks, the great Louis J. Gomez, everybody. Anything else, Louis? Skankfest last weekend in June.
Yeah,
for
man.
Sure?
Well, we're sold out for Skankfest, so you gotta follow Skankfest NYC on Twitter. You get win free tickets. That's the only way to get tickets. That bitch has been sold out in a week. Also, check out my other podcasts. All of them are on the Gas Digital Network, GasDigitalNetwork.com, and that's it, man. Look out for me in your hometown doing stand up. That's it.
I love that. I have a couple other podcasts too. The Pony Hour, available on iTunes, and also the Store Horseman. If anybody's ever been a pro wrestling fan, me and my friends that used to be pro wrestling fans when we were kids all got together and we started doing a pro wrestling podcast. There's over 30 episodes of that already available. Dropped it secretly underneath your noses. We're the number one pro wrestling podcast in the world. The Pony Hour is the number one interview podcast in the world done in a basement between the hours of 2 and 4 on the West Coast. But this is the number one live podcast in the world. That's just a goddamn fact. Brian Redban, take us home.
All right, I'll see you guys later.
Bye, we love you. Thank you, Houston. I love you, Houston.
In my 6'4". It's like that.